I've never done. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning, they are renewed. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also.
Of three boys and three girls, and was brought up with traditional values and learned skills that a young lady in her era should learn. Her childhood can be described as a humble one. Matt became a mother at a young age, but she worked hard and brought up her children with good manners, respect, and some moral values, and you could have won a stricter mother. This was reflected in her second daughter, Monica, as she was the one to get up early and help prepare Matt's breakfast and lunch so that she would be ready by the time the truck horn blows to transport her to work. And on her return, after a hard day's work, her bath would be ready along with something warm to drink. She thrived in her resiliency, always keeping a passionate figure of strength, soldiering on, even when times were rough. Doreen was a devoted Christian, that every Sunday morning and evening, everyone living under her household had to be ready to attend church with no excuses. Matt became a member of St. Barnabas Church, where she was enrolled as a member of the church army at the Mother's Union, where she was always ready for the call of duty. Immediately leaving the church, begging for the harvest or fairs, she was always willing to assist. Her years saw her in many roles, as we know that many people have their own personal experience and relationships with Doreen, and the many versions of her are the teacher, needle worker, advisor, plant whisperer, animal whisperer, as her granddaughter Lana would be told. Then you go to feed the animals, talk to them. But she could not understand why she should, but she tried doing it anyway. She was a baker, talking about that cake and the fruits were soaked for months. You could have wanted better. And if you didn't taste the sweet bread, it was too good for. And the conchine was like soft butter melting in your mouth with or without raisins. One was not enough to taste. It had to be two or more. Cookies are bonnet rocks with the cherry at the top. Bread, always something to give when you drop in on a baking day. Each version of man touched us, because she had great empathy, which made her a very genuine person. She was always in the kitchen or finding something to do around the home. But when 6 o'clock came, it was time to watch days of our lives and be hushing her babies, which were her knees. I could always call a man when I was not sure how to do a recipe, and she would always walk me through the steps of how it's done. After 99 years of life, she was the mother of 6 children, Monica, Angela, Richford, Marcia, Julie, and the late Doris Herbert, grandmother of 25, great-grandmother of 45, great-great-grandmother of 14, and aunt of many. Ma had the most unconditional love, family, and friends, always thanking the Lord for her life, whether happy days or days when her knees wouldn't allow her to stand up because of her pain. This is where one of her daughters, Julie, came into play as her value caretaker, who was always helping her get through her rough nights and days when she was inconsolable at times. Julie was her tower of strength, taking her to appointments and taking care of her before she left the work and after she came back from work. The awareness of the sort of strength that shows us that real love is sometimes unselfish and involves sacrifices and giving. Matt was admitted to QEH on the 12th of February, where she celebrated her 99th birthday on February 15th. She was called to a higher post on the 16th of February, 2022. I don't know if there is a deeper sense of loss than that of a mother, the person who raised you, taught you right from wrong, and brought you into this world. I want to say how sorry I am for the loss you are going through, and that I hope as days go by, it will be well with your soul. We have taken the opportunity today to remember and share Dory's treasured life, and know that it was all of us, her family and friends, who helped her live a long life. May she rest in peace and rest in glory.
Thank you.
died and rose again, even so through Jesus, God will bring to me those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left under the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with the cry of command, with our angels call and for the Lord himself, with the cry of command, if the archangels are angels, the disciples of heaven, then the first of rise first, then we who are alive, who are left, will come up and close together with them to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Here in the reading.
Where I am.
Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where we are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will not know my Father also. From now on, you do not know him and have seen him. Here ends the word.
We shall now have the soul.
You raise me up to all those stormy seas. to be my
in God's forgiveness and in God's salvation. And the passage that I've chosen to reflect on this afternoon begins from the transition between what God has done for us in Jesus Christ and what we now ought to do in the name of Almighty God. And it begins with the word, therefore. Because of all that God has done for us, therefore, we must do what is necessary to live lives in response to God's love. I want to suggest some stuff to you this evening. Because you may think that Doreen's initials of DH are all that there is to her. And if that were only the truth, then there would be little that we could celebrate as we gather here in the house of God. For as the service says, God has given and God has taken away, and somehow we must bless the name of the Lord. But I'm here this afternoon to testify to those who may not really have known her, and also to remind those of you who knew her so well that Doreen had other initials. And it is because of that something extra. It is because of those added initials to her life that the sorrow of her exit from this life cannot equal the joy and the comfort that having lived in her shadow brings. And as I want to bear witness that she had other initials. And these initials were MU and CA. I wonder if anybody in this church knows what I'm talking about. That's right. Mothers Union and Church Army. They stand for Mothers Union and Church Army, but I want to suggest that they signify something far greater than that. They are a reminder to us today that we have come here to bury a body, not the person of Doreen. We are here to bury the body of a churchwoman, a Christian, whose first values related to the Lord of the church. Mothers Union and Church Army, these are symbolic of that, and many of you know how great her love was for these organizations, because her greater love was for her Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. In the life of this modern saint, and in her suffering and dying, the initials MU and CA remind us of all that the Apostle Paul has written about in the first 11 chapters of the letter to the Romans. Because you see, Doreen's faith was not the result of her good works. Her faith was a gift from Almighty God, acknowledged often by her with deep gratitude and with great thanksgiving. She was a person dedicated to the gospel of God, the good news that life is meaningful, that life is eternal, and only in the death and the resurrection of God's Son that you and I can find life to truly live in this world. But there is another set of initials which describe her, initials which grow out of the first, initials which relate to the second section of Paul's letter to the Christians in Rome. The Apostle Paul says, I appeal to you to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, that you may prove that which is the will of God, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. How do you spell that? Well, people can spell it in many different ways because we are all different people. But in Doreen's case, it is spelled out in terms of her great love and her dedication to God's service. Hers was a Christian response. Hers was the response of a person who recognized what God in Christ had done. salvation that was achieved for her through the death and resurrection of Christ. And we call these works good because they are done for others out of the goodness which God has done for us. And that is why we are called as Christians the servants of God. Because you see, you and I are called to witness about our God-given time. And you know and I know that we sometimes waste the time that God has given to us. And the reality is that we do not know how long our God-given time will be. Doreen's God-given time is 99 years. Which one of us in here this afternoon can say how long our time will be? How much God-given time have you got? And we sometimes waste this God-given time. But there are ways in which we should use the time that God has given to us. It might not be 99 years, but every single one of us in here has been given time by God. And we should use that time well. We should use that time to talk to others and to share with them our faith. We should use that time to show others what it means to have a relationship with God and to let them know of God's reassuring love. Because you see, there are many lonely and lost persons out there in the world today. And a few minutes of that God-given time talking to them will not cost us anything. My friends, we also need to find time to pray. Not loud, formal, memorized prayers, but having a conversation with our God, thanking God for the many blessings that God continues to send our way, asking God for guidance in what we say and what we do, asking God for hope and comfort for others, asking God for forgiveness, and praying that with God's help, we will be able to fulfill God's purposes for each new day that God gives us on this God-given journey. Praying that we might be still and listen to what God is trying to tell us as human beings in this world. Doreen in her life and in her worship would have understood these things. Go back to where I started with St. Augustine. You see, Augustine's mother died shortly after his baptism. Today, another mother has died. But who are the real saints in this world? Is it the Apostle Paul? Is it St. Augustine? Is it Monica, Augustine's mother, or is it Doreen? I venture to suggest that we are all the real saints. That you and I are all saints in the sight of Almighty God. And that is what makes today, even in the face of death, an opportunity for celebration. Because in the face of death, we as Christian people, we who recognize ourselves as saints of God, know that God in Christ died and rose again, and that this God in Christ lives, and that we believe in Him, and if we believe in Him, death is not the end for us. Only our bodies die. And that is all that we are returning to the earth today. Because you see, the sorrow of Doreen's death cannot match the peace of knowing who she is and where she is now, for she is in the nearer presence of Almighty God. The loneliness that her death brings cannot equal the comfort that comes from the presence of God whom she so faithfully served in her life. The gate that one's death opens up to us all is covered and removed by the loving forgiveness from the one God who welcomes her into his nearer presence and reassures us
on this earth that she has gone to be with him. What more can we say? We pray for God's love upon all of us. And we commend to God one whose initials are D-H-M-U-C-A. And let us praise God for the service she gave to God and the way in which she served others. One whose name is Doreen Herbert, who has indeed presented herself as a living sacrifice, and who has indeed proved what is the will of God, and what is good, and what is acceptable, and what is perfect. Well done, you good and faithful servant. To those of us who mourn her loss, we extend our condolences, and we pray that rest eternal may be granted unto her, and that light perpetual may forever shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen.
Lord be with you. I want to offer my condolences to the Herbert family, having served in this parish 18 years. There have been a number of persons, of course, we have a very close relationship to, and we would love to come to all their funeral services, but it will be David Christ Church and St. Barnabas always at the beginning of the funerals. But I did indicate to the Herbert family that I wanted them to call me, and they want to be especially here for this funeral service. It can't be at everyone, but I'm here to offer my personal condolences. As was stated, so eloquently stated by Father Monreal, a saint, an encourager, and a beautiful person. May she rest in peace. So stand and just be praying. Our sister Doreen, let us pray to the Lord Christ who said, I am resurrection and life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn, Doreen, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, in your mercy, you wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, in your mercy, raise death to life. Raise our sister to eternal life. Lord, in your mercy, you promised paradise and the thieves repented. Bring our sister the joys of heaven. Lord, in your mercy. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all the saints. Lord, in your mercy. She was nourished with your body and blood, grant her the place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Comfort us in the sorrow of the death of our sister. May our faith be our consolation, eternal life, our hope. Father, Lord, we pray to you for Irene, all those who have been seen alone. Grant them eternal rest, and light perpetual shine. Amen.
You rest, O Christ, your servant, with your saints. You only are immortal, the creator, maker of mankind, the wheel of the form of the earth, and the earth shall return. Pursue your daily greeting, saying, Lord, thus, and thus you shall return. All of us go down with us, and even the grave, we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
You rest, O Christ, your servant, with your saints. There's sorrow and pain are no more, like a sight of light at last.
The Lord's prayer, O oh, Father.
Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Lord.
commend to you your servant, Doreen. Acknowledge we come to beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her in the hour of your mercy, and the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and to the glorious coming of the saints to the light. Rest eternal ground on her, O the Lord. Amen. She will live before the mercy of God. Rest in peace.
Amen. Let us now sing the hymn, I am thine, O Lord. I have heard.
Thank you. good.
Servant, go in peace. Your word.
word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, and light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people, Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal body through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. And in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, Lord God, who are just in life and by your sin. The sure and certain hope of the resurrection, eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our sister who is here departed. And we commit her body to the ground. Dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. That when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our sister Doreen and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. Angels Thank you. Thank you.
Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious unto her. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon her and give her his peace this day and forevermore. Amen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Para con.